Hello again. Welcome to the second panel. I'd like to welcome all of you to the second panel, also our friends in Porto as well. We all learned that they are also following us from Porto. So in the first panel, we discussed the refugee dimension, refugee issue, but we also talked about some of the political aspects of the question. And we also touched upon the meeting taking place in Brussels. But as we all know, the unfolding events in the Middle East and also in particular in Syria is a long one, nearly 50 years. So they are affecting the regional dynamics, but at the same time global dynamics as well, and they are also affected by regional and global dynamics. So we will be also touching upon some of the regional and international issues in this panel as well. And then I will be giving each panel 15 minutes, so we are a bit late according to our program, so we want to finish the program as stated according to the timetable. So the title is On the Way to the Humanitarian Summit in Istanbul. So in Istanbul this year, this May 23rd and 24th, that will be the first UN summit about UN Humanitarian Summit. So as you all know, the humanitarian issues is dominating the agenda of international politics, increasingly because of the local conflicts, civil wars in different parts of the world. So we are increasingly talking about refugee issues, humanitarian crisis. And in the first panel, we already discussed the lack of the international communities, their capacities in terms of responding to this crisis. So there should be an international effort to come together to discuss the ways, the tools, how to deal with this international humanitarian crisis. So, but on the other hand, there should be responsibilities of different specific actors. So we will be continuing to discuss here this panel. And also just another note before speaking, just Mehmet Köse, Mr. Mehmet Köse reminded me, he mentioned to forget. So this is a special address for the students here in Lisbon, also in Porto. He said that his institution is offering scholarships for foreign students, and they can be applied Turkish scholarships online, so you can apply. And this is full scholarships for master and PhD students. So till the end of this month, the application is open. So he forgot to mention during his speech, so he asked me to talk about this issue. So before, without any further delay, I'm giving the floor to Dr. Kani Torun. He's a member of the parliament. He's the deputy chairman of the Foreign Relations Committee, and he was an ambassador to Somalia before his current post. You have 15 minutes.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. When we talk about Syria, actually, there are lots of dimensions. I think as I'm in profession, I'm a medical doctor. So first, you need to find the etiology of the any disease. What is the root cause? So then after that, you can treat properly. So if you look at the last 5 years, the main what I can say, the main problem, the Syrian crisis coming to this stage, there are two main problems. One is the inconsistent policy of US. Second one, unfortunately, European apathy in the beginning. U.S. Started in different way, ended in different way. So in August 2011, President Obama said the Assad should step aside. 1 year later, August 2012, he said that chemical weapons are our red lines. August 2013, regime used chemical weapons towards civilians, and then he changed his tone, and then actually all those red lines removed, and August 2014, they said that Assad may stay until the transition ended. So this is the superpower, and one of the P5 country. Actually, the policy, this inconsistent policy, bring much problems, particularly power vacuum in Syria. Some other countries feel that power vacuum. Recently, as you see, Russia. Then, when you talk about Europe, you know, the two out of five P5 countries are European Union members. So, European Union did not act properly in the beginning, when they started to act, summer 2015, when the refugees arrived. So when the problem come to the doors, then they wake up. So what would be done before this crisis happened? From the beginning, we said that there should be a security zone in the north, so then refugees, actually there would be no refugees. They could stay this in the safe zone without fear, and then neither Turkey nor Europe could now talk about refugee crisis at the moment. But it's still, you know, this not on the table, unfortunately. Coming to the issue of refugees, in the beginning, there were very few refugees. But the war, after the escalation of the war, just 2.7 million refugees are in Turkey, and 1.2 are in Europe. 30% of them are in Germany. So, Europe and US and other countries, in the beginning, worked on the transition of the regime. If they worked on transition of the regime, that could be the situation could be different. From now on, we should still. I'm talking about at in the beginning political issues. Then coming to the refugee crisis. From now on, there is still this possibility to work on political issue. Europe should put more pressure on US and other P5 countries to solve this problem peacefully. The ceasefire, we don't know if it works or not, but still, you know, there is a ceasefire. There are some other elements continue to work on this ceasefire, to break the ceasefire. There are other problems. ISIL, for example. ISIL is a product of this crisis. In the beginning, if there would be a proper action, ISIL would not have been any ground in Syria, as well as Iraq. But as I said, this policy of inactivity brought ISIL, because there were power vacuum. They filled the power vacuum. Then finally Russians came, and situation got worse. Exactly 1 year ago, there were 1.5 million refugees were in Turkey. In 1 year time, we received 1.2 million more. So you see the situation is getting worse. If the Russians still continue to bombing Aleppo and the siege continues in Aleppo, we predict that 600,000 more refugees will come out. So situation will get worse. What can be done, as I said, the political solution first, and then share the burden together. Talk about the refugee crisis. As I said, that last year it was in Turkey 1.5, now 2.7 million refugees. Out of them, 260,000 are in camps, rest are everywhere. One town in the border of Syria, they have more refugees than local residents, called Kilis. So this situation is not sustainable. When the last summer, when refugees arrived in Europe, and then there were big news in Europe, so the German Chancellor Angela Merkel visited a couple of times Turkey, and also there were there was a meeting in October between Turkish government and European leaders, Juncker and Tusk. So in that meeting, after that, that Europe, European Union promised 3 billion euro to for actually the helping refugees in Turkey. So far only 95 million released. All the money actually will be used for Syrian refugees. We already spent 10 billion euro, dollars just in the camps. I'm not talking about the others around Turkey. We don't know the exact figure. So after October, again, there were some visits, particularly from Germany. So we talk about this issue. Actually, I was in Germany about 6 weeks ago. We talked with her party officials. So I see they are very sincere to solve this issue. They want all European countries share the burden with them, not just Germany to take this burden. And this crisis should be solved inside European Union first. Because, as their words, that if Europe does not accept, European Union countries does not accept their plan, they are actually thinking of to abolish Schengen treaty. So this consequences would be much worse than the refugee crisis, because current prediction is over 18 billion euro. That's just the cost of abolishing Schengen. So where we are now, so we are now in a situation that temporary ceasefire in Syria, millions of refugees in Jordan, Lebanon, and Turkey, and some in Europe, and every day they are passing Aegean waters to reach Greece. You know, 2 days ago I read the report. It was very sad that you know there is you know, particularly in Greece and Macedonia, they had you know, the hunger problems. Those refugees, even the some countries, I don't want to mention names, they don't allow UNHCR to help them. So As one of the speakers said, the previous panel, this situation, the fuel the Islamophobia, fuel xenophobia, also the increased support of racist parties in Europe. This is also alarming because this will bring more instability to Europe. So we need to work together. As today, that there is a summit, Turkey and European summit, to share this burden and to find a sensible way to solve this problem. As I said, actually Europe needs, European Union countries particularly needs more effort for political solution, because the refugee situation is just the end product of this political situation. So if you don't solve the problem, this war, unfortunately, has a potential to escalate in the region, because now the Iraq is a very critical situation, and Egypt now also has very critical situation. So if there are more refugees coming, other countries in the region, so this cannot be sustainable. One issue I'll give you a political message to European friends, that you need to be honest towards the Middle East, particularly. Because when you talk about democracy, human rights, and other issues in the West, and then support the oppressive regime in the Middle East, this will not help the situation there. It's like after Egypt coup, what happened. So it is not good to have a double standard. So we need to work together, and one standard for everybody, for every country. I hope that I kept my time very well. So if there is any question, I'm happy to answer. Thank you.